Aquarius, we might think individual genius, we might think humanitarian and groups, we might think the ability to innovate and do something in a unique way or be inventive. But we really also have to focus on certain human realities that go with that part, that way of being. Meaning when I'm bored with something, maybe I realize, oh yeah, I got to get my Aquarius side going. You know, maybe I got to break out of that. Maybe I have to stop doing something in an old way and innovate, or maybe I need to distance myself from some tradition so that I can feel like I have some elbow room and freedom to do something. But there is an emotional component here. There is an emotional toll on us when we do that. So I also want to look at how that emotional component can actually make us not want to innovate. Basically, it's lonely being alone. So people who live with Aquarius energy very strongly or Uranus energy very strongly are just different enough that they may feel that they don't fit in. Some of them feel that they may kind of fit in, but they have to be individual and independent and on their own sometimes. And one of the challenges of living with a really strong Aquarius energy is, how could I be connected but also be independent? And so you'll find some people believing in a false dichotomy. I can't be connected to that group. I can't belong because I have to be on my own. Or I can't be original and be a part of this group. It's a false dichotomy because when it comes to this energy, we have to find the right group. This is part of the task. So we find ourselves in a context, in a situation. Does this work for me? If the answer is no, then your job is to go find the right context. In a sense, Aquarius energy is about trading up contexts in one way. So lots of people who live Aquarius energy are bored. They're not eccentric individual. They're not expressing their unique genius. They are, in fact, trying to be like other people so they don't have to stand out, because standing out is lonely. It's frightening to be, you know, out on the edge of what's happening and not a part, you know, not part of what's going on. So when the sun hits Aquarius, these issues for a lot of different people are activated. What does it take for me to be individual? What would freedom look like to me? And one of the amazing things about living with this archetype is that you, if you're paying attention and if you're willing to learn and grow, is that you figure out over time that everybody, each person alive, has this incredible potential to live absolutely present and in the moment. Yet each person is also shaped by history and what he or she thinks that history means. So that leads me to this other corner of this archetype that's highlighted during the month the sun's in Aquarius, which is the need for objectivity. Not taking things personally, not being so invested in things personally that you can't see the truth of it. This is part of the eccentricity or the genius, the inventor that can come out with strong Aquarius energy. And it is. And part two of this video here is Mercury in Aquarius. Every month I'm going to be talking about when things change signs. So you're going to hear something about Mercury pretty frequently, because its orbital cycle is about 88 days. So, you know, it's always changing signs or doing something. And of course, three times a year we have Mercury retrograde, so that's where we're going next. First of all, Mercury in Aquarius. We've already had this possibility of awareness and objectivity and the potential of detachment being there, because Mercury has been in Aquarius for a little bit. Now the sun enters it and the light is shined on it. So you may have actually been aware of something that seemed to make sense, but suddenly makes rational sense about some way that you're different, where you are or not connected, whether you're bored but need to innovate, something that might need to be changed that way. It's at four, Mercury today, well, on the 19th, I just have to remember I'm doing these videos ahead, but on the 19th, Mercury is at 14 Aquarius when the sun's at zero, so they're not conjunct. But it's not long until they are, you know, until they are. Mercury will enter Pisces on January 31st, so almost 2 weeks from that time. It will enter Pisces, and then at three Pisces, it stations retrograde, which means that it seems to change direction. It seems to slow down and then stop and then change direction. Of course, it never does change direction, but the way the orbits of the two planets line up, as astrology is geocentric, it appears that it goes backwards, and so the energy works differently. Now, when it stations at a little over three Pisces, it will be conjunct Neptune. It's retrograde on the 6th. It enters on the 31st, and then it stations on the 6th. There we go. And it will be just about a degree away from Neptune at 4 Pisces. This objectivity, clarity, originality, intellect, exchange of information, quick connections. Mercury enters Pisces. Oh, my Mercury just tried to go to sleep. So there's this element of it's going, and then Mercury enters Pisces, and it's like, oh, I'm either going to coast, or I'm going to slip, or I'm going to slide. But this whole thing is maybe even seeming to get a little bit away from me. When it hits Pisces on the 31st, it will be an orb of Neptune within four and a half degrees. So this you know, Neptune already being in Pisces. So this will be a big deal as far as where information comes from, how things get done, how they should get done. And I'm inviting you, as I do at every retrograde, to not be stressed out when things don't work according to plan, but understand that there are things that you don't know that are happening.